God standeth sure. The foundation of God standeth sure. In 2 Timothy 2, verse 15, it says, study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. But shun profane and vain babblings, for they will increase unto more ungodliness. And their word will eat as doth a canker, of whom is Hymenaeus and Philetus, who concerning the truth have erred, saying that the resurrection is past already, and overthrow the faith of some. Nevertheless, the foundation of God standeth sure. Having this seal, the Lord knoweth them that are his, and let everyone that nameth the name of Christ depart from iniquity.
Amen.
As a child of God, we ought to be different than everyone else who is outside of the family of God.
Amen.
There ought to be a noticeable difference. There ought to be a difference in our speech, in our conduct, in our conversation, in everything about us. There ought to be a difference, because as a child of God, we have named the name of Christ, and for that reason, we have departed from iniquity. Nevertheless, the foundation of God standeth sure. In recognizing this text, in order to ensure that we receive our promised reward of heaven, it's important that as we look at this text, we understand how important it is to us that we have a sure footing, that we are sure-footed. We have to make sure that we stand only on the foundation that God has set down.
Yes, sir.
Have you ever seen a picture of those, they call them mountain goats? Mm-hmm. And how those fellows can be up on the side of a mountain and they can jump from one spot to this valley big enough to hold 1 foot, and they have all four of their feet on it. They have a certain built-in something about them that they always seem to be so sure-footed. But we're not like that, amen. We have to stand on God.
Amen.
When we stand on the foundation of God, then we can always be assured that we are standing on a firm foundation. In Matthew chapter 7, verse 13 through 14, it says, enter ye in at the straight gate, for wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction, and many there be which go in thereat. Because straight is the gate, and narrow is the way which leadeth unto life, and few there be that find it. When we set out in this life, and we set out on a path, and we say that we want to make heaven our home, there's a certain way that God has laid out for us. And only by following that way, that narrow way, will we be assured of our footing if we step out on a foundation that is not solid. It's only a matter of time that we're going to lose our footing.
Well,
when you think about a foundation, a foundation can be described as a footing, or a foot, or possibly a base, or even a substructure, an infrastructure, an underpinning, or maybe something that has the strength of bedrock. But when you set out to walk through this life, if you do not have God as your foundation, you can equate it to putting on roller skates and trying to skate Oh, by the way, with your eyes closed while juggling knives. Only when we stand on the foundation that God has set before us can we be assured of having a firm and strong foundation. In Matthew chapter 7, if you drop down to verse 21, Jesus said it this way, "Not everyone that saith unto me," because there's a lot of people, unfortunately, who believe that they are actually walking on solid footing, when in reality, they are not. In theory, they believe that they are walking the way that Jesus would have them to walk, but in fact, they are not. So Jesus says here, "Not everyone that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father which is in heaven." He says, "Men will say to me in that day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in thy name? In thy name have cast out devils, in thy name done many wonderful works." But watch this. "And then will I profess unto them, I never knew you. Depart from me, you that work iniquity." What is the problem, Jesus? They're not walking on a firm foundation. When God says this is the way to walk, this is where to walk, this is how you should walk, but we choose to do otherwise, our foundation cannot, it will not hold up. It will not hold up upon an examination. It will not hold up when problems come our way, and as soon as something happens, then we fall flat on our face. Why? Because we set out on a foundation that was not sure. But Jesus says, I want you to know this. In verse 24, "Therefore, whosoever heareth these sayings of mine and doeth them, I will liken him unto a wise man which built his house upon a rock. And the rain descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew, and beat upon the house, and it fell not, for it was founded upon a solid foundation." Listen, Jesus is that solid foundation. Here's the alternative. In verse 26, it says, "And everyone that heareth these sayings of mine and doeth them not shall be likened unto a foolish man which built his house upon the sand. The rains descended, the floods came, and the winds blew, and beat upon the house, and it fell, and great was the fall of it." What was the difference? Did not both of these individuals have a house that was built? Mm-hmm. Were they not encountered by the same problems? Did not the rain descend on both? Did not the floods come on both? Did not the wind blow on both? Were they not both beat upon? But what was the difference? One had a solid foundation. Amen. What is your foundation built on this morning? I just want to ask a couple of questions, then I'm going to sit down. Y'all owe me some time back. Some of God's time back. I'll get it back. We'll get it back. Amen, Lord. Is your foundation built on the Lord Jesus Christ, or is it built on Satan? Just curious. Is your foundation built on sand, or is it built on the rock? Is your foundation built on lies, or is it built on the truth?
Amen.
Is your foundation this morning built on carnal things, or worldly things, or is your foundation built upon spiritual things?
Yeah.
Is your foundation this morning built on despair, or is it built on hope? Sometimes we live our lives, and it seems as though all of our foundation, our structure is built upon despair. Everything that can go wrong seems to go wrong. But if you're here this morning and your foundation is built upon despair, why not try hope this morning? The foundation that you're walking on this morning, that you walked in here on this morning, was it a temporal foundation or is it eternal? Your foundation, is it earthly or is it heavenly? Is it of turmoil or is it of peace? See, you can't stand on a foundation and say one foot is on solid and the other's on unsolid ground. If you want to make heaven your home, you have to create a foundation. You have to stand on the foundation of God. Why? Because it standeth sure. It is a sure thing. Listen, when you serve God, you're not taking any chance. When you go to the casino, and I know nobody here go to the casino, every time you go to the casino, every time you purchase a lottery ticket, every time we choose to do what's wrong versus what's right, we're simply taking a chance. But when we stay with the Lord, we're always where we need to be. We're always on a foundation that is always solid. There are no ifs, ands, and buts about where we are and what we're doing because we're always standing on a solid foundation. And God has laid out that foundation.
Amen.
Are we going to be troubled? 2 Corinthians chapter 4, as I close it. 2 Corinthians chapter 4. Are we going to be troubled?
Yes.
Yeah, we're going to be troubled. But I'm so thankful for what Brother Paul wrote for us in 2 Corinthians chapter 4. He says in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 7, but we have this treasure in earthen vessels, that the excellency of the power may be of God and not of us. See, when we rely on ourselves, that's not a sure footing. You know, I trust myself more than I trust anybody. But I can't 100% fully trust myself sometimes. You ever thought about that?
Mm-hmm.
Most of us probably trust ourselves more than we trust anybody else. But even when it comes to ourselves, we can't put 100% trust in ourselves. Why? Because sometimes we would like to think what we would do in certain situations, amen?
Amen.
But then when confronted or encountered by the situations, it's not always what we have practiced and prepared for. So it says here, but we have this treasure in earthen vessels, that the excellency of the power may be of God and not of us. Listen, it's not about us.
Amen.
It's about God.
Right.
So he goes on to say in verse 8, we are troubled on every side. Did anybody come here this morning in trouble?
Amen.
Everybody came here this morning, everything's going well in our life. Like the man that stood on the shore and looked out and said, it is well with my soul. Did we all come here this morning saying, it is well with my soul? I would like to think that we all did, but we all probably didn't. We're troubled on every side. But Paul says, yet not distressed. We are perplexed, but not in despair, persecuted, but thanks be to God, we're not forsaken.
Mm-hmm.
Cast down. Have you ever felt cast down?
Mm-hmm.
Have you ever been down to the point where you felt like you've just been forgotten, forsaken, you've just been cast down and cast away?
Yeah.
Well, the world may have had you feeling like that, but the thing about God, we may have been cast down, but we were not destroyed. He says in verse 10, always bearing in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus, that the life also of Jesus might be made manifest in our body. But we which live are always delivered unto death for Jesus' sake, that the life also of Jesus might be made manifest in our mortal flesh. We have the same spirit of faith according as it is written, I believe and therefore have I spoken, we also believe and therefore speak. Knowing this, verse 14, that he which raised up the Lord Jesus shall raise us up also by Jesus and shall present us with you. Listen, let's not give up. Let's stand on the firm foundation of the Lord. Times are going to be tough, amen. But who in here has not gone through tough times before?
Amen.
And guess what? Tough times are going to come. But if I know that I stand on the foundation of the Lord, the foundation of God standeth sure. That means when I stand on the Lord, it does not matter what may come my way. The winds may come and be upon me. I may twist, I may lean, I may be even knocked down, but guess what? I'm going to get back up. Because God is there, and I'm with him.
Amen.
And if God be for us, it don't even matter who may be against us.
Amen.
If you're here this morning, you're not a child of God, you ought to become one. How do I become a child of God, preacher? I say it at the beginning, I say it at the end. By being obedient to the gospel of Christ. What you have to know is this, and I'm so thankful that we don't have to know the whole Bible in order to be saved, amen.
Amen.
But what we do have to know is this, the gospel of Jesus Christ. Jesus died on the cross of Calvary. He was buried, and he rose again the third day. You heard that story. Do you believe it?
Mm-hmm.
If you believe that story, are you willing this morning to have a change of mind? If you're willing to have a change of mind, are you willing to confess with your mouth that you believe Jesus Christ is the Son of God? Do you have your sins washed away in the water of your baptism? The water's ready, the clothes are ready, the angels in heaven. The Bible says there's more rejoicing in heaven over one sinner who repented, and there's over 99 just and need no repentance. Don't you want to cause commotion in heaven this morning?
Yeah.
By your action? By you stepping out on faith this morning and declaring with your mouth that you believe Jesus Christ is the Son of God and being baptized into the body of Christ? The one that he's coming back.